प्रोफेसर विवेक साठे ऑफ WIT सोलापुर. ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस फोर वीडियोस ऑन द स्टेबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया फॉर कंट्रोल सिस्टम्स. नाउ टुडे इज द फिफ्थ वीडियो इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टाइप टू एरर दैट वी एनकाउंटर इन प्रिपेयरिंग राउट्स टेबल. एंड दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज आफ्टर फिनिशिंग दिस नाउ यू विल बी कंफर्टेबल टू सॉल्व ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स इन दिस चैप्टर एज वेल एज इन द रूट लोकस एनालिसिस. एज यूजुअल there is a learning outcome, means when your session is over, you will be able to identify type 2 difficulty and analyze the same. What is the meaning of analyze? Analyze means you have to make a comment, system is stable, unstable, marginally stable and so on. Okay. Now, first of all, I will say, see that type 1 error that we have already discussed, and you have learned it, I will just revise it. In type 1 error, we have seen that necessary condition is satisfied by the equation. That is, it is a complete polynomial and there are signs of all the terms are also positive or negative. That is same sign. But as it is more than 2 degree equation, there is no necessity that it is a sufficient condition. So we have to prepare a Routes table because we cannot factorize the equation of a higher degree. So there is a method for it that is called the Routes table. So in preparing the Routes table, the procedure is known to you. Odd number terms we write as the first row, then even number term as the second row, and there is a procedure that is taking the element in the first column, second element as the first pivot element, we complete the Routes table. But in the preparation of Routes table, if we come across a zero, then it becomes very difficult to complete the next rows, because for the next row that zero is a pivot element which is to be divided. That is, that comes in the denominator, and zero divide error is a big issue in mathematics. Zero divide error is a big issue. So how to resolve it? So there are two ways we have seen. We can replace this zero by an epsilon, which is a very small positive number, and work with epsilon. Then in the first column, we'll get some numbers and some epsilon terms, and we take the limit of that as it tends to say zero. And if that terms comes as negative, then we count the number of sign changes in the first column. If the number of sign changes are there, it must be because the system is unstable. Always remember, there must be some sign change. As you have encountered with type 1 difficulty, now type 1 difficulty means we have encountered a zero in the first column as well as at least one element in that row contains one non-zero element. That is very important because today we are going to learn the type 2 error in which we get first element 0 in the first column, that is some element in the column 1 as 0, but additionally all the row elements are 0. But that is not the case with type 1. In the type 1, only first column element is 0 and all other elements are not simultaneously 0, at least one is non-zero. So this is very important, you must fit in your mind. At least one element must be non-zero. But for type 2 difficulty, all the elements must be 0. Okay. So that was our criteria, and when type 1 difficulty arises without any problem, we say that system is unstable. Why it is unstable? Because the roots are going to be on the right hand side. And how many roots? If it is a complex pair, 2 roots. If it is a complex quadruple, 4 roots. If it is a real number, real root, 2 or 1, depending upon whether I get my sign change in the very last column, first column or not. So there will be two roots will be there, and most probably we will get that roots as the complex conjugates, and they are on the right hand side of the S plane. So system is guaranteedly unstable. Now, we are taking today a different problem. Now this problem is a fifth order polynomial which is given to you. Now if I ask you, check whether the problem satisfies both the necessary conditions. You will say that yes sir, no problem. It is a fifth order polynomial. All the terms from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0 are present, and all the coefficients have the same sign. So it is an equation which is eligible for necessary condition. And sufficient condition, we cannot take, say, immediately. We have to prepare a table. We have to see that whether type 1 difficulty arises or not. Then we start preparing. Once again, I do the revision for you. Odd number terms are written over here. Odd number terms. This is first term, third term, then one, first, second, third, fourth. This is the fifth term, and this is the second and second term, this is the fourth term, and this is the sixth term. So odd number terms are 187 and even number terms are 487. So these two that we get from the data, this we get from the data, that is given equation. Now with the help of these two, we form the third row. How to find the third row? Once again, I have a small revision again. This is my pivot element. This is my pivot element. So this A 4 into 8 is 32 minus 1 into 8 is 8 divided by 4. So 32 minus 8 is 24 divided by 4 is going to be 6. So I get 6 here. Similarly for this, 4 into 7 is 28 minus 4 is 24 divided by 4, again 6. So I get 6 and 6. The next third row I obtained. Now for this row, fourth row, this is the first row, this is the second row. So this is the pivot element. So 6 into 8 minus 6 into this divided by 6 is 1. And this is also 1 that we get. And next row, this is the first row, this is the second row. And if I do this, I will get 6 minus 6, 0. And for this, there is no term, so it is 0. So all the terms in this row are 0. Now see here, what is important for type 2 difficulty? In type 2 difficulty, we must get a situation in which entire row is 0. So this entire row is 0. And in type 1 difficulty, only this is 0 and at least one is non-zero. Okay. Now if this entire row is 0, this is called as type 2 difficulty. But there is a different, estimation, or there is different, comment that we have to put when the system has a type 2 difficulty. As we said, the type 1 difficulty ensures that system is guaranteedly unstable. Listen, type 1 difficulty is guaranteedly unstable. Type 2 difficulty is also unstable, no doubt. But there is a possibility that system may become marginally stable. So marginal stability is an important aspect of a control system which is unstable, no doubt, but it is still stable. For example, in our IC engines, cam is moving the valves. It is oscillating, is it not? But that oscillations are fixed. Means it is oscillating, so there is continuous variation in the output, but output variation has got certain fixed order. So that is called as a stable system. But in a control architecture, if we require a system in which oscillations are required there, then it is a stable system. So I require an oscillation of fixed frequency, and I know that is my stability. So whenever we encounter type 2 difficulty, we have got marginally stable system. Now what is the meaning of marginally stable system? Means there are roots lying on the imaginary axis. So whenever I draw the pole zero plot, real axis and imaginary axis I show over here, so my roots will lie here. There may be pair of roots here, or the situation may come which is very funny, that I will get four roots like this, that is minus A plus or minus B like this. So these roots are called as quadruples. Means it is minus A plus BI, minus A plus BI, minus A minus BI, plus A plus BI, plus A minus BI. So this is a mirror image of this, this is a mirror image of this, and this is a mirror image of this. So this is called as a quadruple. So these are the possibilities that I can get when I have type 2 difficulty. Out of this, whenever my roots lie on the imaginary axis, I know that system is going to be marginally stable. Then the problem is how to solve it. So there is a very simple method. You identify the row which is having all the zeros, then look at this row, a row above this row. So this is this row. So what are the coefficients? 1 and 1. What is the power here? 2. So I will get an equation S square for this and plus 1 for this, because this is, here powers change by 2. If it is a fifth power, this is a third power term, one power term. If it is a fourth power term, this is second power term, this is zero power term. So if it is a second power term, this is zero power term. So I will get S square plus 1 is equal to 0. This is called as auxiliary equation. This is called auxiliary equation. So you differentiate this auxiliary equation with respect to S. I will get 2S is equal to 0. I will get 2s is equal to 0. Now you replace the coefficient of this s, which is 2, by this, and there is no constant term, so 0 will be there as it is. 0 will be there as it is. Now this is 2 here and 0 here. Now you complete your table. Now you can complete because there is no problem in it. After completing your table, you can see that all the roots are no root is lying on the right hand side. Means roots are lying on the imaginary axis and our roots are in the left hand side. So because of this, if the roots are there on the imaginary axis, system is marginally stable. So we make an important comment that it is marginally stable. But when it is marginally stable, means if it moves to the right, it is unstable. If it comes to the left, it is stable. And on this, it is on the verge of unstability. Then what is the frequency for that? If I want to find out the frequency for that, so on this axis, I got omega. So frequency is obtained by substituting this equation equal to 0. So I will get s square is equal to minus 1, s is equal to plus or minus I. So plus or minus I means 1. So 1 is my radian per second is my frequency. Okay. Now see, what we have seen, type 2 difficulty arises when we get entire row 0 in the Rouse table preparation, then that is resolved by looking at the row just above it. And that row is always an even powered row. It never comes as an odd powered row. That is the mathematics there. Then we form an auxiliary equation, which is s square plus 1. We take its first derivative. That becomes 2s plus 0. And we replace the coefficients of the row where the zeros were obtained by these coefficients, that is 2 and 0. And then we further complete our Rouse table and do the analysis. But always remember, with type 2 difficulty, system is marginally stable, and for marginal stability we can find out the frequency, and that is obtained by equating the auxiliary equation equal to 0 and the root of a particular equation, that is s square is equal to minus 1, that is plus or minus I get the value of 1. So 1 radian per second is the frequency for, that is the critical frequency or natural frequency of this particular system, and this is required for us to draw the root locus in our root locus chapter. So I think with these 5 videos, you have got a clear-cut idea about discussing the transient behavior, then prepared necessary condition, sufficient condition for a quadratic or up to quadratic. Then if it is a polynomial of more degree, we have to satisfy the sufficient condition. And for sufficient condition, it is not possible to always calculate the roots or factorize the particular equation. So we have used the Rouse table. Rouse table may encounter 2 difficulties, type 1 difficulty. In type 1 difficulty, first element is 0 in the first column somewhere, and all other elements are not necessarily 0, at least one is non-zero. Then we replace 0 by epsilon, or we replace s by 1 upon z and do the regular thing. Type 1 difficulty systems are always unstable. Then sometimes we come across type 2 difficulty where entire row becomes 0. Then we see the row above it, which is always an even powered row. Then we form a polynomial, which is known as auxiliary polynomial. We take its first derivative and its coefficients are replaced by the row of 0 zeros, and we prepare a table. So when a system is having a type 2 difficulty, chances are there the system is marginally stable, and its frequency is obtained by equating the auxiliary equation equal to 0 and solving for s. So this is all about our, transient system. I think you have got a clear cut idea about this. Now, those who are interested, you can, refer to the references that are given in, this particular, slide, Raven, Bakshi, and Barpatte. Thank you for your patience listening. Good day. Thank you.